makes it sadder.
Astronaut Stephen West was returning from outer space. But something terrible had happened.
Remember now, his mind is so completely decomposed.
We've got to find him.
He's going to need human cells to live on.
Stephen West had turned into the incredible melting man.
And the more he kills, the longer he's going to live.
Melting Man is the first new horror creature. Come prepared.
He was created out of violence and horror. He exists only to destroy the evil around him. He can't be reasoned with or bargained with. He can't be stopped. So if you've been bad, look out. Your worst nightmare come true, the Toxic Avenger. If you've been bad, he'll get you good. Rated R, under 17, not admitted without...
Starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
Who is Darkman? Find out this summer.
Can't you be original for a change?
funny. Are you through playing with yourself?
At least I'm playing with a full deck.
Hey, Hutch, give me that.
Are you ready in 20 minutes? Where are you going?
Didn't I tell you? Like, I promised Mom I'd get him at least once a week.
The last time we brought him to a party, he threw up all over one of my girlfriends. And that was before he started drinking.
Come on, he's not that bad.
Well, I'm surprised you haven't invited the tag along to bed with us.
Don't worry, he probably wouldn't know what to do.
I'm glad his older brother does.
With your lips? I can't.
Sure I can.
You're hired, sweetheart.
Oh, I told you, I don't mix business with pleasure.
We just wanted
to. Do I talk to you about business at the animal sanctuary?
Come on, Mike.
Or ask you about life as a locker room attendant? I mean, hey, Joe, tell us about the latest athlete's foot disease going around.
Well, it's pretty darn serious.
Hey, did you hear the one about the leper at the hockey game?
No.
There was a face-off in the corner.
That's an old one.
What did the leper say to the prostitute?
What?
Don't worry, you can keep the tip.
Oh, I get it.
Come on, Mike, you're avoiding the issue.
Yeah, tell us about your scoop.
Look, I've told you as much as I can. I'm on the verge of my biggest story. I mean, when it breaks, I'm gonna sell this baby to every paper this side of Albuquerque.
Well, can't you give us a hint?
Or don't you trust us?
Of course I do. It's just that... it's a bit dangerous.
Dangerous?
Don't worry, I can take care of myself.
Well, if it's dangerous, maybe I should be involved.
Have you gone to the police?
Police? Please! That's the quickest way to leak a story. I'd lose my exclusive.
Well, if it's dangerous, I should be involved.
Listen. Read all about it next week, okay? Besides, I'm missing my final piece of evidence.
Moron.
Yeehaw! Faster than a speeding bullet!
Oh, slow down, you'll kill him!
Nah, little poor boss for it. Don't!
Yeah, next time I'll drive.
Talk about taking out the garbage.
Ouch.
You are so mean to the guy.
What a big brother's floor.
Can we talk about something? Well, I'm a little concerned about this story of yours, and
not that again. All right. Tomorrow I have a meeting with the board of directors at the Barley nuclear plant.
What for?
Well, it's regarding some serious negligence. What I'm hoping for is an admission of guilt. I mean, that would be like the icing on the cake. with the confessor. Not, it's still a landmark story.
Confess
that...
what?
If I give away the ending, you ain't gonna buy the story.
Mike, where are you going?
It's a surprise.
I'm robbing the leech with lifestyles of the young and shameless. Champagne wishes and caviar dreams.
Oh. It is a picnic, symbolic of our milestones, our first date, our first kiss, our first...
What's the occasion?
Of all the headlines I've ever written, and all the headlines I'll ever write, this is my masterpiece.
Oh my God!
Actually, I was hoping for more than your hand.
Hey, boo-boo. Look what's in the picnic basket.
It's not for you.
Come on, get lost.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I'm so sorry, but I finished all of the cracker, Jack.
I do. I mean, I will. I mean, I am.
I take it the answer is yes?
Don't you understand? You're already in enough trouble as it is. This power plant is lethal. You've not only ruined the environment, but you've killed hundreds of people. If you admit your guilt, maybe you can save your ass.
Guilt? What guilt?
Come on! Your containment center is ineffective. Nuclear waste is leaking out.
Unfounded lies.
You have no proof. Proof? You want proof? What about, Miss Kathy Miller, Mr. Larry Brown, Mrs. Joyce Milton, and the list goes on and on and on. Over 200 people who live within 30 miles of this complex have developed terminal cancer. And those deformed babies are no freak accident either.
Mr. Wade, I think we've had quite enough of your fanatic ramblings.
Ramblings? Look, Dick.
Call me Richard.
Sorry. Richard, now you know, and I know, that this containment center is faulty. And in a few days, everyone else will know, and you'll be exposed. And there's not a damn thing you can do about it.
Well, if it's our containment center that's bothering you, why don't I give you a personal tour?
A tour?
You haven't seen it yet, have you?
No.
Well then, why don't I show you around? And once you see how safe our little operation is, then I'm sure you'll realize how unfounded your accusations are.
Why am I reluctant to trust you?
Of course, if you're afraid.
After you, Dick.
Highly toxic. Of course. Nervous, Mr. Wade?
Where's
Where's the transfer tubing? Underground. It carries the waste up to the storage station,
where it's kept in tanks
and buried in dump sites across the country. Very good, Mr. Wade.
My environmental studies prove that there's a leak, and I know that the leak is here.
Of course it's here.
What?
Some of the waste leaks out of the transfer tubing and into the ground.
But then it contaminates the water and the soil.
And the air. Of course. Diddy.
Why are you telling me this? You know that I'll write it down.
Afraid not, Mr. They don't have typewriters where you're going. Teach you to mind your own business.
My girlfriend knows I'm here, so call the police!
You don't expect me to believe that, do you?
There's been a terrible accident.
I couldn't even find his body. An accident. A goddamn stupid accident.
Rochelle, there's nothing I can say that will bring Mike back or ease the pain. But life goes on, and life is for the living. Do you think Mike would want us to sit here feeling sorry for ourselves? No. He'd want us to go on, pick up the pieces, and remember him for all the love and fun he gave us. Things happen for a reason. We have to learn to accept fate. There are greater forces in this world beyond our comprehension.
Give me a fucking break.
Well, it was worth a try.
He's dead. Final, no more.
Well, you've got a good point there.
God, I miss him.
Can I take you home now?
I know you're trying to help.
Come on, Rochelle.
Can we read back the proposals, please?
First proposal, that the office of deceased reporter Mike R. Wave be penetrated by board member Rob Burr, and any incriminating evidence be removed and destroyed.
I second.
All in favor? Motion passed.
Second proposal, please.
Proposed that Rochelle Darlington, girlfriend of the late Mr. Wave, be eliminated from society to compensate for the possibility that she may possess too much knowledge.
Second. All in favor?
Just a moment. The method bears analysis. What type of termination would be systematically cost-efficient and garner the most long-term benefits?
How about death through multiple knife wounds?
No. Too time-consuming.
A fatal shotgun wound to the cranium?
Wait. What about a simple decapitation?
Sure. Don't lose your head over this.
Hold on. I have an idea. But if she's sexually assaulted and then slowly asphyxiated?
Now that sounds good. They'll never suspect us.
I second.
All in favor? Motion passed.
I'll supervise this proposal myself.
Good. Now, what's next on the agenda?
I'm alive. I need your help.
This is a sick joke.
Don't you recognize my...
That the office of deceased reporter Mike R. Wave be penetrated by board member Rob Burr, and any incriminating evidence be removed and destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
such a hothead.
Sorry, Rochelle. Look, I'm taking off. Can you lock up for me, please?
Sure.
Okay, see you later.
See ya. Yes?
Hello, little girl. Are you lonely?
What? Who is this?
How about some company, little girl?
Is that you?
But if he's sexually assaulted and then slowly asphyxiated.
To daddy.
Jeez, you salesmen will stop at nothing to get in.
Joel, for Christ's sake, open up.
The joke's on you, buddy. My brother's dead.
Buzz off, creeper. I'll call security.
This building doesn't even have security.
I already called the police. You'd better hope they get to you before I do.
Joel, let me explain. Give me a chance!
Not you again. Go away! I've already got three sets of encyclopedias.
Open up, it's me.
Rochelle!
Someone just tried to kill me.
What?
A man in the sanctuary. He tried to, and then he wanted to kill me.
No, it's okay. He probably didn't mean it.
I don't understand. Why?
Sit down. Calm down.
Phone calls.
Calls? What calls?
Someone really sick kept calling, pretending they were Mike.
Really? Same thing happened to me?
The police aren't even investigating. They say he was trespassing.
Well, if he was trespassing, there must have been a good reason. Did Mike mention anything to you?
No. He didn't say anything.
He must have hinted at something. A name. Anything.
Only that he was going to the power plant. And something about negligence.
They must think you know something. I'm going to the police.
With what?
What about Mike's notes? Interviews? Where does he keep them?
In the office.
Do you have a key? Well?
What is it?
Just some background stuff. Wait a minute!
What now?
You should look at this. Let's look at this. I think it's Mike's research on the power plant. What's wrong?
Huh? Oh, nothing.
Come on, then. We got a lot of reading to do before we go to the police.
Too bad it wasn't enter at rear.
Hi there, tall, dark, and mysterious. Flash me those baby blue.
Hey, babe, I got a 6-inch tongue and I can breathe in my ears. Well, if you were 3 feet tall and had a flat head to set my beer on, I'd consider it.
Big boy, what's better than roses on your piano?
What?
Tulips on your organ.
Hi. I'm Peter Fonda. You must be Fonda Peters.
breathing ground.
It's only fair to warn you that I have a very serious social disease.
Who doesn't, sweetie?
All right, then.
Kiss me, baby.
Usually I don't have to pay for it.
I'm sure.
Well, how about a discount?
How about a get out of here?
Just kidding.
Nice car you got.
Thanks, babe. Yeah, I'm busy right now.
Let's hurry. My wife's gonna be home in an hour. Give it to me.
No, you can't have it.
I said, give it to me now.
You ain't gonna get it.
But I need it, please.
Look, I ain't into threesomes.
So what?
So it's gonna cost you extra.
I don't care.
Well, I guess I just saved myself some money.
Come on, I ain't got all night.
Right. Fool me. Yeah.
Oh, you're so big and strong.
Are you sure you really want to go through with this?
Yeah. Wow, you really get into this, don't you?
Publicly by facial blemishes? Oh, those ugly blackheads. Kill them dead. Annihilate acne. Toxi 5 medicated skin cleanser penetrates past 3 layers of dirt, grime, and oil. Our product contains benzoyl peroxide and carbon tetrachloride. For flawless skin, use Toxi 5. It kills acne dead.
Hey, buddy. Hold on.
You were going way over the limit, asshole.
Was I?
Let me guess. Your speedometer's busted, right?
No.
You're rushing to the hospital because your wife's having a baby.
That's not it.
Well then, dog breath, what's your excuse for speeding? Testing out your new car?
Actually, it's not my car. I stole it.
Hey, Bob, bring over the breathalyzer. We got ourselves a real wise guy here.
What's with the sunglasses, weirdo?
It's a long story.
Okay, buddy. Stick the tube in your mouth and blow.
If you insist.
Thank you.
shotgun wound to the cranium?
I knew you'd come back to me, honey. I knew you'd forgive me. I knew you couldn't keep away from me, because I'm irresistible. I missed you. I really, really missed you.
Not tonight, dear. I have a headache.
Think I had a spare rib.
Negative on that, Dave. The area's clear. You sure that dog saw something? Over.
Nah, probably just got wind of a gopher. Over.
I'll keep an eye open. Over.
Thank you.
How can I explain? Shit. Dearest Rochelle, how can I explain? Darling, you look radiant. May I?
He has a lot of my features, but the poor kid has your skin. I guess this solves the breastfeeding issue, darling.
Solitaire champion, as she, or should I say he, loves playing with himself. Next, let me introduce you to the two-headed 400-pound pygmy. Among Elmer's hobbies are sword swallowing, fire breathing, and wabbit hunting. Ladies and gentlemen, I've saved the best till last. You've seen him in the movies. Perhaps you've caught his stage production. Well, here he is, live and in person, the original Elephant Man.
Peanuts, ice cold drinks, popcorn, peanuts.
Popcorn Man?
There's never any hot water. Wait. What about a simple decapitation?
Yes, you've been a naughty little girl, all right.
Norman?
Do you have a cold? Is there something the matter with your voice?
No. My complexion's gone all the hell. And it glows in the dark, babe. Jack Lye from the Barley Power Plant. I have to talk to you.
I have to tell you something.
You're going to have to trust me.
You're not making any...
Your boyfriend. He was murdered.
I have the evidence to prove it.
You have proof?
I need your help.
But you have to go to the police.
Oh, no. No police. Not yet. I'll be there in 20 minutes.
I've been trying.
Joe, a man from the power plant has called.
What about?
He says he has evidence. He can prove that Mike was murdered.
Did you call the police?
No, not yet.
Well, what are you waiting for?
He wants to talk to me first.
What?
He said he was coming right over.
I'm coming right over. And don't do anything till I get there.
Joe?
No, it's Jack Lye from the Barley Power Plant. I only need a minute of your time.
Michelle?
The method bears analysis. What type of termination would be systematically cost-efficient and garner the most long-term benefits?
A long way down. Wouldn't it be a terrible thing if you were to fall? A terrible thing.
Grief over your boyfriend's death? How it drove you to the desperate act of suicide?
Suicide?
Yes. Didn't I tell you? You kill yourself by either jumping off this building or blowing your brains up with this gun.
Of course, you do have 5 seconds to decide which.
Hold it right there!
Boy, you two really took your boyfriend's death seriously, didn't you? Where were we? Oh, yeah. 3, 2...
Hold her right there!
Not again.
Sorry about the mess. And that was my favorite dress, too. I suppose this isn't the right time to bring it up, and, you're probably not gonna believe this, but it's me. Mike.
Mike! No! You're a liar!
You've got my ring on.
What?
My ring! You remember? Love, crazed reporter requests your hand in marriage? Of course, I was hoping for more than your hand.
Mike?
One and only.
I can't believe it's you! I'm so glad. This is incredible!
This means the wedding's off. It's still me. I haven't changed. Are you suggesting that our relationship was purely physical?
My God, Mike. Look what you did!
He deserved to die.
Look what they've done to me! This is worse than being dead.
You don't understand. If I could just make
it... Go away! Just go away!
Rochelle, is that you?
Should have worn my cape, huh?
Don't talk.
Come on, bitch.
Okay. Why don't you go home and get some sleep? Why wasn't there an investigation into my fiancé's death?
The report was quite clear. He was trespassing and he had an unfortunate accident.
He was killed.
Now, what makes you say that?
He told me.
Excuse me?
Well, he's not really dead. I mean, they tried to kill him, but he survived. And now he's badly disfigured and on a rampage.
Thank you, Miss Darlington, but it sounds like you've been watching too many bad horror movies.
But you haven't even looked into...
Maggie, would you send an escort in, please? Miss Darlington is leaving.
I have proof. Mike's research on the power plant. They're the ones who killed him. Or at least tried to kill him.
Maggie, would you hold off on that for a moment? Now, what's this all about?
Mike had proof that the board of directors were covering up something serious at the power plant. They knew about his investigation. That's why they tried to kill him.
That's a pretty serious accusation, ma'am. Tell you what, leave this with me. I'll look it over. Maybe we'll start an investigation.
I really appreciate this.
Well, I hope we can help you.
Joe?
Where am I?
Shh. Take it easy.
What happened?
I'll get those bastards.
One thing I love, it's a wet pussy.
She said, a murderous, disfigured ghoul? Sounds like my ex-wife. Are you sure that's the only one?
I'm sure. She brought it to me herself.
Good. You know, that woman is more trouble than she's worth. Burn it. Could you set up an appointment for me with her?
Should be easy enough.
I'll take care of the details. Shall we put this towards your retirement fund? Yes?
Sorry to bother you at home, sir.
Who is this?
Security at the plant.
This had better be important.
In the containment center...
What is this about?
There's been a horrible accident. We found a body, sir.
Have you called the police?
No, we called you first.
Good. Good. Hold off on the police. I'll be right there.
For my facial reconstruction.
You and your two best men at my office in 1 hour.
No cost.
I don't care.
Who is it this time?
Just bring lots of equipment.
You may have some trouble.
Don't worry, Mr. Swell. We aim to please.
Oh. in here.
Okay, Mr. Swell. You've got yourself one less worry.
Hello.
Michelle Donnington, please.
Michelle speaking. Who is this?
Police Chief Bullocks. Listen. After reading over your boyfriend's evidence, I've decided to put two detectives on the case.
Thank God.
Well, due to the nature of the investigation, plus the fact that we're dealing with some political heavyweights,
would you be willing to cooperate with us?
Of course.
Great. Well, we'll take you to a safe house and put you under police protection.
You're serious?
Nothing to worry about. It's standard procedure.
How long should I pack for?
An overnight bag will do.
I'm sure this won't take long.
Swell residents, who's speaking? Sir, it's the Cancer Research Foundation. They're requesting a donation.
Tell them I gave it the office.
He's not
This is Michelle Darlington.
Hi.
You're in good hands, Michelle. This gentleman will take care of you.
Can I take your bag, ma'am?
No, it's okay, thanks.
Right this way, miss.
Take care, Miss Donovan.
Bye-bye.
Michelle, you bring your bathing suit?
No, I don't know how to swim.
Oh, what a shame.
Let me introduce myself. I'm Swell. Richard Swell. Your friends call me Dick. I see you heard of me.
You bastard!
Now, now.
You won't get away with this.
You know, you're almost as stupid as your boyfriend.
Not quite. I went to the chief of police.
Chief Jones?
No. Chief Bullocks.
Nice try. Sergeant Bullocks and myself have a wonderful working relationship. I buy him the odd drink, the odd dinner, the odd car, and he makes sure that I don't get into too much trouble.
Prick!
Call me Richard. You really should have taken those swimming lessons. You know, your boyfriend had a most unfortunate accident. Just like the one you're about to have.
Siamese twins.
Leave me alone.
to.
No!
I can't go on.
Please!
Because I love you.
Mike!
Thank you ever so much for watching another fine late night feature. I hope you enjoyed watching as much as we enjoyed showing it to you. Right, Lightning? Oh, sure, Lightning enjoyed showing it to you, too.
That's it for me, Joe Bob Briggs, reminding you that those who live by the sword get shot by those who don't. Did you guys hear the one about the knights who are leaving for the Crusades? And one knight tells his best friend, "My bride is without doubt one of the most beautiful women in the world. It would be a terrible waste if no man could ever have her. Therefore, as my best and most trusted friend, I'm leaving you the key to her chastity belt to use should I not return from the Crusades." So the company of knights go out, and they're about a mile or so out of town when they notice a cloud of dust approaching from the town. They think it might be an important message, so they halt, and a horseman approaches them, and it's the knight's best friend. He runs up to the knight, and he says, "Hey, you gave me the wrong key." Joe Bob Briggs reminding you that the drive-in will never die. And speaking of the president, the U.S. Treasury has announced that it'll sell three new types of Treasury bonds starting January 1st. The Al Gore bond, which has no interest. The Monica Lewinsky bond, which has no maturity. And the Bill Clinton bond, which has no principal.